Welcome to two examples of how to express information in an application problem using function notation. In our first example, we're given the amount of power in kilowatts per week, big P, used by a company to produce T tablet computers is given by P equals F of T. Again, where P is the number of kilowatts per week and T is the number of tablet computers. The computer produces 800 tablet computers and uses 1,250 kilowatts of power in 1 week. We want to express this information in terms of the function f. So the power used is 1,250 kilowatts. So we have 1,250 must equal f of t, where t is the number of computers. So in this case, we'll have f of 800. So we've now expressed the information in this application problem using function notation. But often you'll see this switched around. We can also write f of 800 equals 1,250. And again, the input is the number of computers produced in 1 week, and the output is the number of kilowatt hours used. Let's take a look at a second example. A salesperson commission per week in dollars, C, is based upon the number of cell phones sold, P, is given by the equation C equals F of P. So notice again, P, the number of cell phones, is the input into function F, and big C is the commission earned. The salesperson sells 45 phones in 1 week and earns a commission of $650. Express this information in terms of function F. So again, big C represents the commission, which is $650. This is equal to f of p, where p is the number of cell phones, so in this case, f of 45. So here we have the information expressed using function notation, but as I mentioned previously, this is often written in the reverse order, so we can write this as f of 45 is equal to 650. Again, where the input into our function, in this case, is the number of phones sold per week, and the output is the commission earned in dollars. So here's just two quick examples of how function notation can be used to express information given in an application problem.